Thank you. to stop that. Or women, I can maybe. You know, we're seeing women do that. So when a horse does that, when you're out here, it's gonna spend a lot of time thinking about horses in the business, especially horses that can be, you know, done competitions and shows and stuff like that. They get when this is a tense place, they can never relax enough. So to me, that's really exciting thing for you to have to relax. That's what I've got. conversation, two or more individuals sharing their understanding of that building, even principles. That's what I, my very first time, I thought I'd just talk about those principles. And I tried to put those principles to use in those four things, online, and everything, and then leads and lead changes and flow motion terms. And that's what I've been doing for 30 years, is put those principles to purpose. Do unto others as they walk down unto them, and that's where And I see that a lot. Some people learn the 7-8, they don't use the 7-8. They don't do it. The first time I saw a yoga game, one of my teachers, one was shaking my hand with his left hand, just putting his finger in his forearm, back it up. Up the ramp, not in the water, up the ramp in the song. He just put his finger in the back. Why didn't he look at me, shake my hand, take the body with his finger? His horse going backwards, and up the stop.
It's not just something that's happening to you. I talk to
has 3 feet, so 4 feet, so that means two of the feet have to hit the ground at the same time. It's the yellow one's going to the left, it's the white one's going to the right. Raise your hand if you just want to say. This is important for you to learn because if you don't know this, and
you need it.
If you're pretty sure what I said, 90%, 99% of all people who will do, they trot around here to the right and they rise with the yellow feet. What they should be doing is rising with the white feet.
Let's switch, everybody.
Now, what lane is he on? He's on the right lane. Who's ever had somebody call him? You're on the wrong lane! Okay, so he go to your left and stay on that lane. This is what some people would call the wrong lane. He's on the right lane, folks. Going to the left. This is called a counter canter. Can you see it looks more awkward to do that?
Four.
Lord, however, it may be 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, not every day, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1.
Thank you.
Say the word now when I see it. Ooh, you guys are good. Because last time I brought them, they said now they want to change direction. But Slido changed directions, and then he changed needs. All right? Any good reports?
Together,
right? So whenever I want to as we start to get our horse connected to us, the big secret is to get behind the horse. So right, as he comes across to me, I'm going toward his other horse. Right? I'm going to let this right now watch him. It's the hardest one. Squeeze everything out of it. See him move his other horse? So whenever I go, if I can, I mentally kind of put my gaze on it.
Right? So what do most people do? They lean forward when they want to get as much to guard, as much for bookies.
horsemanship, these war savvies, these agents of this. And you know, we have 10 levels in our program. What we have been able to do is put together the first 4 levels in such a way that you can take it all away. And you can study it and you can do it. The other stuff, you can go anywhere and get an ICE and it will And then it comes light bulb. I'm aiming right hand and foot. So now those are tall. Change of leads. A simple change of leads. Now here's another one. I can change direction. It's called a bow tie. This is called a tape. So over here, make a circle and come to a walk. And just as I thought, see the hind legs over here and pass the horse face intense to canter. I have a good chance of getting the left lead. And so I just put this little finger in pattern over here. We call it a bow tie. And the time. It's pretty easy for a horse. Did you lead you on? You slow me down. Aim your defense before you get the fence messed up. And I've helped thousands of people. Different kinds of horses around the world learn how to get their leads just by giving this little tool for the way this bow tie pattern. Now, you go over here, you take the bow tie, and we aim the hind foot, make a circle. I'm going to do a circle to here. Now, slow it down, do the right hand flip, and up, circle to here. All right? Slow it down a little walk. Make sure you have right foot lean, and circle to here. All right, that picture. Now, what if we don't shorten the circle, keep up a little bit? What if we, instead of making 16 figures, do a little one like this? Then we do what Pete did. Come from here, do it on a straight line, short the circle, not just go, plank foot, aim into the S, 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 right hand foot, aim into the S, left hand foot, aim into the S. Let's give Slider hand. Sideways this way, then jump, sideways that way, then jump. So you guys think, if you do it from home, lots of ladies, open up the door and get a lot of time to get away with the room. Here's my suggestion. I said, put up and read the horse. Remember what I said, put up and so good that even the horse off the room. If you can't do these new changes, take this a girl's question, girls. How long does it take you to tell if a man does not have a dance savvy? Less than a second. Does this mean you've got a lead? And this is where if you look at riding, horses know what we know. They also know what we don't know. But a lot of people don't know that they don't know what they don't know. They don't know that the horse knows what they don't know. So they got lots of trouble because they just don't know it. So all I can do is give you a little light here and just say, these are the four things you really need to think about. You need to learn when you're leading the horse on the ground, he doesn't look down the rope and down the lead rope and think, oh, why do I have to go? Why do I have to go? And whenever they're doing it, they're going, then whenever you're laying for the trail ride, you're sure you want to get that trail, they go, oh. And then when you do ride, can you ride with some understanding of the dynamics that are naturally built to all those horses? And when you know that, this afternoon, I'm going to give you another demonstration of how spins and slides and stuff like that, okay? On Slider. But then I'm going to bring you a horse that needs to be restarted. I'm going to try to show you how I'm going to pay attention to certain things, and in that horse, we'll be able to build out the slides again to make sure everything's pieced together. But knowing what the end, hore-man-ship is that you have it deep in your heart, strong in your heart. Last night we did it with my husband and his daughter. And I was going to go to the emotional aspect. 3 months ago, I listened and had to that leg amputated. And he still wants to ride that, wants to ride horses, he still wants to be that. So he has to ride that. Because it's strong.